A judge ordered that he remain behind bars. Nora.
Jeff Begays, thank you. President Trump's performance in the polls has Republicans worried about the race's down ballot. In the Senate, Republicans are defending 23 seats, Democrats just 12. If Democrats flip just a handful of seats from red to blue, they would win control of the Senate. We get more now from CBS's Nancy Cordes.
With 11 days to go, Republicans are worried that the president's sagging poll numbers and controversial campaign style could cost them not just the White House, but the Senate, too.
I felt kind of bad after the first debate. Quite frankly, I felt good last night.
Take Senator Lindsey Graham, who is running for re-election in the ruby red state of South Carolina, but is now virtually tied with Democrat Jamie Harrison, who has outraised him by tens of millions of dollars. The CBS News battleground tracker shows Republican incumbents trailing by 4 points in Iowa, 10 points in North Carolina, and 11 points in Arizona. With the Senate currently split 53-47, Democrats need to net just 3 or 4 seats to win control. And there are plenty of ways for them to do it. Of the 14 races CBS News considers very or somewhat competitive, 12 involve seats currently held by Republicans. With Democrats now pouring money into reach states like Kansas and Texas, GOP donors have rushed in to level the playing field. Casino magnate Sheldon Adelson and his wife giving $75 million. But it doesn't help that senators are stuck in Washington, finalizing the confirmation of Supreme Court nominee Amy Coney Barrett instead of back home campaigning. Senate leader Mitch McConnell is hoping to wrap up soon. He's up for re-election too.
We will give this nominee the vote she deserves.
Even if Democrats have a good night on election night, we still may not know which party controls the Senate for months. That's because there are 2 Senate races in Georgia that look like they are going to go to runoff elections with Nora. Get this.